everyone. I am Prerna Nisar from DEHCC, and today I am going to explain you a skin effect. So basically, skin effect undergoes two AC and DC currents. So let's talk about DC. Let's take a conductor which is ACSR, and DC current flows from it. So the flux distribution in this conductor is uniform. Consider this is suppose the cabin, and flux distribution is uniform in this case, and there is no loss in our DC. But on another hand, if we take a conductor which is ACSR, and if AC current flows from this conductor, then flux distribution is not uniform. The flux distribution is at the center. So, as we know, this formula L is equals to psi upon I. As the density at the center increases, psi increases. Because of that, inductance also increases. Because inductance increases, XL increases, and because of XL increases, impedance increases. So, as impedance increases, current decreases. So, current decreases. So, current starts flowing from the outer part of the cable. In case of DC, the area of conductor is equals to area of current. But in case of DC, area of conductor is not equals to area of current. So, when in AC, when in conductor, AC current flows and density at the center is very high. Because of density is very high, psi increases, then inductance also increases. Because inductance increases, by this formula, XL increases, impedance increases, and because impedance increases, there is no current, and that's why the electrons start flowing from the outer part of the cable. This is nothing but the skin effect. So resistance in AC is in the center is much higher. So resistance of AC is nothing but 1.38 times to the resistance of DC. Thanks so much.